What were you up to this time last year?
March 9th of last year, we were opening Endlings at New York Theater Workshop.
I was playing Maria in West Side Story on Broadway, you know?
We had just started the first week of our six-week, what we hoped would, you know, would be our six-week spring fundraising campaign.
This time last year, I was kind of feeling like, you know, everything was going so well. We were kind of peak season on Broadway, right? So everyone is gearing up for what's going to be the crazy, like, onslaught of openings.
So this time last year, I was pretty confused because our sacred place of performance was no longer available for us to sort of be in. And there was no sort of answers as to when it was going to be back. We just knew that people were getting sick and it wasn't safe.
I was the hair department head for Six the Musical, and we were getting ready to open because our opening night was going to be March 12th of 2020.
Those new rules will go into effect 5 o'clock on Friday, except for the Broadway theaters in Manhattan, where it will go into effect 5 o'clock today.
I think, like everybody, I thought that this was going to be a pause for a few weeks. But then when it became more than that, I was like, aha, this is not so good anymore.
It was really difficult to realize that it was going to be so long. As we're inching closer to a year, it took me a little while to wrap my head around that, like, we were going to get to a year.
My initial thoughts on this was, wow, a snow day, how awesome, you know? And then it was like, no, this is much more than that. And this is something so serious and something so unheard of.
The day after, on I guess the 13th, that Friday, as things really began to move so quickly, we sent the staff home, in fact. And by Tuesday, I think it was the 17th, March 17th, we had begun our first online campaign, which is our COVID-19 Emergency Relief Fund.
I had just come back from London, where my husband was doing a reading of a show. And so I remember being over there and hearing kind of the rumblings about COVID and hearing that word getting tossed around. As March rolled along, going into those shoots in the theater, and all of a sudden it was like, you know, there were kind of placards up in the lobbies that were talking about, okay, we need to have everybody hand sanitized. But everyone that was in my circle seemed to kind of have the same idea that it was like something kind of in the distance.
I knew it was going to go on for a while because I do, just for me personally, study infectious diseases as a side hobby. So I'd been following this particular coronavirus since the end of 2019, and I didn't think it was going to be as short of a time period as our government was saying it was and other people were saying it was. I knew it was pretty serious, but I did not think that it would go on for this long.
As it became evident that we were going to be in this for the long run, what was the most difficult thing to realize for you?
I think for me, the part that was initially the hardest was when the show I was working on at New York Theater Workshop closed. My personal sorrow in that regard was more for the people that I was working with than for myself, because I was lucky to be in a position where I just finished one process and was about to start another. I had closure, but they didn't.
To realize that, nothing is promised, and people around you are dying, and also, like, our performance is gone, and not only gone but like shut, like sealed, and it was just a reminder of the reality of the situation, and that there was no sort of plan to come back, but more sort of plan to just seal it all.
I mean, I don't know that it hit me immediately, but just what shutdown meant. You know, it's like when the electricity goes off in your house or apartment and you're sort of shocked by how much you forget is run by electricity. Really, just what this meant of how sequestered we were all going to be. Not just the fact of going to a show, but everything that surrounded that. You know, from restaurants and ancillary businesses and cabs. I mean, everything that basically was flatlined. And for us at Broadway Cares, in terms of what we do to fundraise, it knocked everything down like a row of dominoes, because everything that we usually do is connected to some sort of engagement with other people.
The beauty of this community is that I think for so many of us, this is more than a job. You know, that it's not just that I go and clock in and pick up my camera and take photos of production on a stage and leave and put it behind me. I have always been such a theater kid. I've always been such a an artist and wanted to spend my days doing that, that to have that taken away without much choice has been hard to wrap my head around, you know, on a kind of constant basis.
For me, it was, who am I without work? Because so much of my life has been spent working, because I love it. I love what I do and I enjoy doing it. And I've been very grateful and blessed to have had a good career both on Broadway and in TV and film. But without it, I had to figure out, who am I? What is there to me other than the fact that I do hair and wigs? And it was tough. It was very depressing for a while to kind of realize without that, I didn't know the answer to that. And so it took a while to figure it out and try to find more of a purpose in life outside of work.
Things have changed a lot in the last year. Are there changes you hope we can keep as an industry as we move into the future?
I definitely think some of the things we're going to keep is just access to stuff and the ability to see projects that we really want to work on and being able to put them up, even if it's virtually. Helps with artists who maybe aren't given the opportunities to get their shows that they write or shows that they're really excited about onto a stage. If they're able to get it on a virtual platform, we're still able to enjoy it and still able to experience it, and then they get to workshop the stuff.
There's a place for all kinds of mediums in the theater in some form. I hope that we will return in full force to live theater in buildings, but that we will keep some of the things that we've learned this year that have made making that theater a little bit easier.
I think that in this, when people are sort of reimagining works, or, well, when they're putting out new works, that they are looking at the broader spectrum of casting what the world looks like today and what our theater community is these days, and sort of revamping the structure of casting and revamping the structure of our storytelling.
I hope that the sanitation aspects that we've all kind of picked up this year will continue, that people will be more mindful of other people and their space and what they're going through. Moving forward, I sincerely hope that productions, both in front of the camera and behind the camera, move forward in a way that promotes a greater level of diversity and inclusion in a meaningful way, not just a superficial way. I want to see real change because we deserve it.
Certainly what's also happened at this time is the entire conversation about equity and equality, you know, and racial justice. And I would hope that what we'll all be doing is sort of re-examining our own behavior and consciousness and speech in terms of how we interact with each other. All of that change is going to be about new ways of being, if you will.
As we reflect on this past year, what are the positive aspects you feel you are taking away from the year?
I've been lucky to take a step back and consume a lot of art. What I've learned this year as part of being an artist is taking in art and having that just as a reference point in your head and using it to like enrich you as a human. And I think that that was sort of always the thing that fell off the list for me because it seemed extraneous, but it actually is what sort of like feeds your soul.
One of the positive aspects I'm taking from this year was, you know, the idea of evolution, you know, and sort of putting on different hats of performance. The thing that sort of inspired that was seeing, you know, our community sort of evolve and change and slip through the cracks of the downward. As things were getting bad, you see the artists rising up to sort of spread their light and share their light and gifts. and come together to make change and to show change and to be the change. And that sort of lit my fire to continue to grow and continue to be strong and continue to be positive and continue to work.
It gave me an opportunity to really learn more about myself. I just got out of college and like hopped right into being in a Broadway show. So like, there were still some things that I needed to know about myself that I want to do in life. I'm releasing some music this month. It's been really exciting to like talk about myself and be more open about who I am.
I think for me, I'm hoping that I will continue to have a little bit more of a boundary in terms of like, you know what, I did my job and now I'm going to go and have my actual life.
I moved to LA. I've been in New York for 7 years and I got an opportunity to move out to LA and I took it. For me, that was a nice silver lining at the end of the year.
What I'm really proud of is how flexible both the industry, but also particularly Broadway Cares has been able to be. I mean, we've awarded the Actors Fund since last March, probably over $10 million, like $10.5 million. That's more than we did in all of 2019. I think when we first thought shutdown, the scariest piece of this was, does that mean we can't do that anymore? Does that mean all these folks who depend on us from the Actors Fund and folks in the industry to hundreds of thousands of folks who were also being challenged by COVID, does that mean we were gonna drop out as being a place of refuge and support? You know, I'm thrilled to say that with the collaboration with folks like you and thousands of others, we've been able to sustain that, in some cases, even grow it.
I think a lot of us were surprised to find that time off, even though it wasn't what we wanted, did give us the opportunity to rethink how we were living our lives in the theater and beyond, and make sure that we were making art in the happiest, healthiest, most productive ways. So I'm excited to see how we all come back to the table and what we bring with us from the past year, despite all the difficulties.